things like magnetic induction and electromagnetism and things like that. Just amazing stuff. One is an induction heater. Have you seen these induction hot plates?
Yeah, what do you call them?
Oh, yeah. Cooktops.
My uncle's got them.
Oh, man, that's a freaking work of art.
Yeah.
I'm having a lot of fun with that. And, of course, it's the beautiful thing about it is it all boils down to Faraday's law, which is it's that simple. And if you look at it, you say, well, wait a minute, so V equals IR. Then you can solve for I is the partial of V with respect to T. That means this is a time-dependent variable, which means if I take a bulb, a slowly alternating voltage, and try to couple one to another winding, you'll get a certain current level. But the faster I make that oscillate, what do you think your current level does? So, you have a hot plate. Have you ever seen these things? They're amazing. You put the freaking thing on, you put the pot on, and I'm struggling. I'm violating all kinds of wisdom. But making it work. You should ask Rudy. He saw it. He walked in. He goes, what the hell is that? But the point is this. I couldn't believe how fast the metal was heating up. And this has to be huge.
Yeah.
How huge can it be? It can't be more than 60 hertz, right? I took an oscilloscope to it. Guess what the modulation frequency is? Modulate the 24 kilohertz on the 60 hertz waveform. It looks like this is really cool. And you get this 24 kilohertz thing going on there. I broke the Jesus out of my hand, not knowing I have something like a moron. I turned it on. Surely it can't heat up instantaneously. It heats up instantaneously. So anyway,
one of those thoughts.
So cool, it got me on the path. I've turned my poor wife. My office is at my house off the kitchen. I've turned the kitchen into my lab now. My wife comes home and there's oscilloscopes on the counter and there's wires all over the avocados and there's, you know. So, but it's pretty cool. I mean, this was cool. And in fact, I wish I could show you some of my experiments. They're just so cool. And they represent, they confirm these equations so beautifully. We'll talk about it. Anyway, and I'll tell you as much as you want to offline if you want to know. So, today's the last day of class. I can't believe it's gone by so fast. I'm going to pass this around, Mr. Kane, if you wouldn't mind. And so today's plan for today is to finish up the presentations. I've got a list. We've got seven more people, but I know some of you are teaming up, so we have at most six, I believe, unless we have multiple people teaming. So, Jonathan, you're going today?
Yes.
And Carla? Okay, cool. Carlos, were you teaming with Rosa?
Right? Yeah.
Okay, cool. Gina, you were going today? Ray, are you ready? Cool. Kingsley?
He's not in yet.
Okay, and that's it. So we just have those. If we can finish those, I have a lecture prepared, a two-part lecture prepared on my thumb drive. I'd like to get to, but we may not get to it, which is fine. If we do, we do it. There's some really cool stuff in it I'd like to leave you with, insofar as things to think about, how you can really connect your liberal arts backgrounds with engineering, which the class is about.
Is it on campus?
It is. It is on campus, as a matter of fact. However, if we don't get to it, there is a last 5 minutes of it, we have to get to. It's my debrief, which is also on campus. It's literally the last two slides. So whatever happens today, even if we go into the 4 o'clock, if you give me 5 minutes of your time at the end, I'd like to just debrief you on that last thing. It's some inspiring things I want to say, inspirational things I want to share with you. So personal things I want to share with you. Tell me what I really think of you. That's a good thing. And then I'm going to give these to Tam. I'm going to go ahead and give you these now. If you guys would mind, not mind, I'm going to leave you. When I finish my debriefing, I'm going away. I'm leaving the room, and I'm not coming back. But I'm going to leave you with these, if you would fill these out, and then return them to Tam. And Tam, if you wouldn't mind taking them to Dr. Walston's office. That's the evaluation. Okay? All right, so I think, are we ready, Rudy? Are we ready, Rudy? That's a quick little tongue twister. We'll begin then. Why don't we start with, and one more thing, if any of you see Chris Kuhn or Tyler Park, if you would ask them to contact me, I'd appreciate it. Try to keep that as low key as I can, no big deal. And with that said, why don't we just go right down the list, unless you don't want to, then I'll any way you want. We'll start with Mr. Abrahami. All right.
So my project is still sort of just an idea, just because I lack both the knowledge and the means to actually put it together at the moment. So I respectfully ask that you sign these non-disclosure agreements, or if you prefer not to, that you can vote.
No, yeah, we can. That's a great one. I like that. You see what you started? This is awesome. This is good. Like, I feel like I'm on the Stanford. This is so freaking cool. Hey, congratulations, buddy. Give us a minute to sign these. I'll fill one out too. You want us just to sign the last page?
Yes.
Okay. I'm sorry, did you not get one? Sorry. Oh gosh. I'm losing it. And the date. What's the date?
16th.
All right, I'll come back around and pick them up. Everybody sign them. I trust it's a generic one, because I didn't even look over it.
Yes, I think
everyone
signed it.
Okay, cool. Anyone not sign the roll? I don't think you deserve it.